When we look at the Hindenburg, where is the oxygen there? I love it. All around, right? So it just so happens that I came in extra early to make a bottle of hydrogen and oxygen. So I've got it right here. So do you guys want me to light this on fire too?
Yes.
Okay, cool. All right, let's do it. Morning. It's about 6:45. Happy Friday. I hope you had a great week with your students. A lot went on this week. My students were doing some reviewing for our unit assessment, and of course we're starting our brand new unit today. So I'm in school very early because I need to set up for our phenomenaling. Our unit is chemical reactions. I'm really excited about this unit. I'm starting this unit a little bit differently than I have in the past with a brand new phenomenon. So I'm gonna go set that up and then I will check in with you a little bit later on. Good, lift it up. Thank you so much. Good job. Okay, here we go. And there you have it. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. You take hydrogen, you take oxygen, reactants. What's your product? Water. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you had a great week with your students. This week was jam-packed full of stuff. My students had their unit assessment on intermolecular forces this week. That took place on Wednesday, and so we spent the bulk of the first half of the week preparing for that. I created one of my task card reviews. We also revisited our phenomenon, the evaporation race. All in all, it was a great week. If you're not sure what a differentiated task card review is, I'll definitely put a link down below so you can know what I'm talking about. But basically, the students reflect on the major themes in the unit. So for example, one set of cards was based on polarity, another set of cards was based on identification of intermolecular forces, and then another set of cards were based on intermolecular forces in explanation type questions, like with different phenomena. And so the students rank their confidence in answering each question type, and then will go to their respective lab stations where these cards are located if they're struggling with that particular content. It was great. I think what I love so much about the differentiated card sorts is that the kids communicate with each other so well. It's great to watch them explain and work together to try and figure it out. This week, I also had time for the kids to reflect on the first half of the year. We no longer are requiring midterms, and so the students really don't have kind of like a cutoff for when to think about, you know, how they've been doing for the beginning of the school year, like they have in the past anyway. So what I decided to do was let them think about a SMART goal that they want to set in chemistry. I did this last year, and I also have a video on this as well, which I would be happy to link down below. But they want to set SMART goals right now because as the year goes on, it's going to get increasingly more difficult. The content definitely gets more difficult, brings back a lot of the cumulative information, but of course it incorporates a lot more math-based stuff. So we set our SMART goal yesterday, and that leads us up to today. Today we begin our unit on reactions. And as always, I started with a phenomenally experience. It was a crazy day.
I wanted to say I was double fisting, but really I was triple fisting with all my carts. Like you can see, like it was just insane trying to drag my carts around today, but well worth it because the kids had a great time. It was a really good day. I actually called today Fire Friday because we were definitely lighting some stuff up. But we were trying to explain the phenomenon of basically making water, right? Like how is water made? So the students were synthesizing hydrogen gas, collecting the gas in a test tube and igniting it. So we were focused on the ignition of the hydrogen gas in the test tube. So the students constructed explanatory models trying to explain both on the macroscopic and microscopic what these observations are. This was their first go around at creating particulate models. Every model, you know, when you're first starting out is not going to be a good one. And I always start with the class talking about essentially a disclaimer, like your first model is not going to be the best. We often leave here with more questions than answers, but you do the best you can and know by the end of the unit, you'll know exactly what's going on. So, and I think because of that, the kids did a great job. They know that eventually they're going to understand it because we definitely have built a very trusting relationship at this point. As we progressed through the phenomenally experience, the students, as I mentioned, constructed their model for the test tube, but then I wrapped in the Hindenburg and how that also resembles the reaction in the test tube. And so we focus on the similarity between the two and the students say, oh, it's the same reaction. And I said, okay, so if it's the same, then how come both of these things didn't do the exact same thing? And the kids all say, oh, Miss R, you need more hydrogen. And so this morning I came in and I synthesized hydrogen by using zinc and sulfuric acid and I filled it in a water bottle. So I took the water bottle and I ignited the hydrogen and the kids saw the little puff and they were like, wait, that's it? What? This is crazy. That doesn't make sense. And I remember one class in particular said, oh, we were wrong, which I love. Like, I love that they said, oh, we're wrong. And then they smile about it because then they think about it and they're like, okay, like what could have happened? And so as a class, we discussed not only do you need hydrogen, but you also need oxygen. And so I did have a bottle that was filled up with both hydrogen and oxygen. And wow, was that an awesome reaction. The students were amazed by that. They were so excited. They thought it was so cool that we essentially made water and the major explosion that accompanied it was pretty intense. And so the kids were modeling that and thinking about what that means. And we even were able to incorporate some of the balancing aspect of it, some energetics. It was great. It was a really fantastic phenomenon. So next week, we are going to be focusing on the Hindenburg again, but this time around, we're going to be focusing on, like, I guess the controversy as far as deciding, like, what actually caused the Hindenburg explosion. So there's some great Mythbuster video clips, and then I'm also going to use that Chem Matters article to introduce, like, the controversy involved. So, yeah, it was a great week. It was an exciting week, and I'm exhausted, of course. Teacher tired is a legit thing, but I think that it was a great way to end the week. And of course, I have a stack of grading like this big because the students took their test, and I'm hopefully going to get through it this weekend. So with that said, I am going to get out of here and enjoy my long weekend. I hope you have a long weekend and you don't have an in-service day. I will certainly check in with you next week and let you know how the stations go. Talk to you soon.